Image planes are used often in Maya to make the modeling process easier. And what I've done here is I've captured a model with photography under two different lighting schemes so we can see multiple types of reference that we're going to model on top of. So I have my front view and my side view, but these aren't the only photos that I've taken. I've also taken photos with more extreme side lighting. And this makes the model's figure pop. I can see a lot more muscle detail showing up. And that will be very useful when it comes to texturing and sculpting. For my image planes, I'm going to use the more evenly lit version so that there's less distractions. And what I'll do is I'll go to my image canvas size and I'll double the width of my front view. And I'm doing this so I can compare the front view and side view directly side by side. And what I'll do is I'll drag the side view into the front view's canvas and I'll trim the side view just using my marquee and hitting delete to get rid of it. And I'll crop the image just to the width of the two reference photos. And I want to make sure that my rulers are on. So view menu, rulers. And once I have the rulers turned on, I can drag down from the rulers and I'm going to create a bunch of guidelines to match up my front and my side view. So what I'm looking for are distinctive points on the front view, such as the edge of the clavicle or the nipple, that also show up in the corresponding view. The underwear here is a good point that I can compare the two references to make sure that they're lined up. Now, the lower leg will not line up. We're not going to be able to do anything below the knee. Don't worry about it. And generally, we'll see that there are some mismatches between the two. So I'll use my edit transform tools like scale and rotate to make changes to the side view. Our front view is our dominant reference. We want our side view to match our front view, not vice versa. Now, once I'm done adjusting, I'll save it and then I'll crop my image to highlight either the front or the side view. So right here, I'll just crop the front view and I'll save that out as its own image. And then I can use my history menu on the right here to step back to the uncropped version and I can save out the side view. And I want to save these at as high a resolution as possible and I'll use JPEG to reduce file size. And then I want to jump into Maya. Importing our image planes into Maya is pretty easy. We just have to hit this Import Image Plane button and assign the correct photo reference to the corresponding viewport. So the front view gets the front reference. And I'll click the button again for the side view and bring in the side view reference for the side camera. And I'll just double check placement. I'll create a plane and I'll use it the same way I use those guide rulers in Photoshop. I just want to make sure that my image points match up. I'm not going to make any changes to my image planes in Maya, but if I see a mismatch, I'll need to double check my files, see if I missaved or if Maya scaled it or something. And when I do this, I'll see that my front view is rotated a little bit. And this is not uncommon. Our model will move or the photo is a little bit off center. We just want to double check and make changes if we need to. And when I do make a change to the front view, I want to double check and make sure the side view still lines up. And then I can just delete the image plane in Maya, re-import the new image plane. And now my image planes are set and I'm almost ready to begin modeling. I need to push the image planes away from the center line. Otherwise, they're going to overlap my models when I'm trying to model on top of them. Okay, one last step. I'll click on my image plane to select it. I'll hit Control A to go into the attribute editor. And at the very top, I'll select looking through the view so that I'm only seeing the image plane in the orthographic camera and I'm not seeing it in my perspective view. And now my image planes are ready to go. So I can begin the character modeling process and you can watch the video where I use these image planes to create this character here.